Real full of them.
Green chilies.
They're not.
Yo.
Oh.
Oh. So what's going on? What's the project for today?
It's not much of a project. We're cutting out a drumstick.
Dude, drumsticks require precision sanding work.
That's why I keep telling him, we're just going to make one, and then I'm going to go out and buy some actual proper drumsticks.
No, make two.
And then...
Look, just cut it in half, right there.
Well, you can't cut it in half, because then it would be too long.
Why? Well, then cut the ends off or something.
You don't want giant long drumsticks?
No. It's bad enough that it's popular, so it's light as hell.
Oh.
And pretty damn flexible.
So what we're doing is we're starting on a MIDI drum.
Okay.
For Alan. It's a project he's been wanting to do for a long time.
All right.
But we don't have any drumsticks around, so we're just going to make one.
Okay.
And I'll be back next week with some proper ones.
Okay.
I'll be maple, because that's what you use.
You could probably find some maple around here.
Ready?
Yes. Are you going to be able to cut it? Because I don't know. Yeah, there you go.
Yeah, there you go. He's smart. He knows what to do. He actually works with wood. I don't.
You guys could have just shifted.
Just gonna let him roll to make sure it doesn't.
So yeah, so just stick a slot with and put a little bit of metal in it.
They're just meant to test the pads that we're making today.
So what are you doing? Gonna sand the tips or?
Yeah, I'd like to turn them so I could chuck them up if I can figure out a way to get this thing to rotate sideways a little bit.
Okay.
This is how we make a lathe out of a drill press.
Good luck. Alright, so you chucked the thing in. Oh, look at that! That's pretty impressive.
I'm not gonna give it a full taper, Alan, because it would take for freaking ever.
That's fine.
This should be enough for testing, yeah?
Like I said, we didn't even have to make the actual tips for testing.
Oh, but what fun would that be?
It would definitely save time.
Oh, we're only like a few minutes into this.
About 15.
No, it's not as good.
Problem with you kids these days. No patience.
Look at the Pokemon.
Shiny. All right, more oval or more teardrop?
I think that means it's good.
I think that's fine.
Alright, just taking off the flat end right now.
I'm going to keep these as a souvenir and immediately replace them with proper sticks.
Your drumsticks are going to be famous on the internet. Give them to Morgan. Let her beat on stuff with them.
They might actually work for her. They're about the right thickness and length for kids.
Voila. Very nice.
Bugs me.
Yep.
It's
I'm gonna fix it.
Okay. Have fun.
Like a pottery wheel, but faster.
Boom. Looks like you figured out a way to use the drill without the base.
Yeah, it's been crooked since we got it too, so when I put it back, I'll actually get it straighter than it ever was. Lucky.
Cool.
So, let me turn it here and you can actually see. There's just some set screws over here.
Okay.
So that's how to work on something longer in a bigger drill press than what the platform and table allow.
Cool.
Make sure you clamp it, because your center of mass would be off.
Yeah.
To the side a little bit.
Are you gonna do any black on this?
Orange arrow.
Oh, is that the name?
Second coat, success.
Okay, so we got a piezo element attached to a couple wires, which, and I think the element is attached to this.
It's not attached to anything.
Oh, so what are you guys going to do with it?
We're going to put it on the underside of this rover piece,
okay,
which is going to act like a pad, act as a pad,
okay,
with the wooden backing plate giving us a bit more bounce, so it actually...
Okay.
Functions a little bit, but actually, that's a bad drumstick.
I don't care because it's such a small.
So it kind of replicates what a drum feels like.
Yep.
And this will go to the MIDI controller, and then from there we can have it do different stuff. Like when I hit close to it, it acts like a full impact hit. Whereas if I hit over here, it has very low velocity, and so it sounds very quiet.
Okay.
At least that's the plan. I leave that to him.
Yep. All right, sounds good.
And then eventually at some point we're going to make actual decent sized drums instead of 12 inch by 12 inch squares, because that's just ludicrously massive.
Yeah.
And it's square.
Yeah.
But this is just a proof of concept.
Alright, sounds good.
We're gluing the element to the rubber with super glue.
Okay. Yeah, that's what I mean. Trying hard not to flip it. Accelerant. It is an exothermic reaction.
Way more powerful than, say, a toaster, even though it's the same thing.
Right. We need a resistor either way. And a scissors.
Right, but that's kind of.
Did it still move?
Let's go in the wood shop.
Yep.
Let's do it. Clear arm.
If I could actually cool the resistor.
All right.
I think we give it a minute to let it set.
I have to.
Yeah, so I think
and then we're going to glue this thing down to this wood after we cut the wood.
Oh, with spray adhesive.
Yeah, like general purpose 45.
Okay,
we got to let that set first, though.
Do you think we should drill a hole through the wood so that we can put the wire through?
I was just going to run it along out to the edge. What do you think?
I think
we can totally do a hole through the center of the bottom, though.
That would give us a spot where if I hit it, it would be hitting the wire. Could affect how the pickup works.
All right.
Which it would be a tiny little spot, but how much would it suck if I'm on a roll and then I hit it and well, now that's all screwed up.
Would the hole affect it though? If it's like right before, right below it.
If we put the hole right where the piezo is, no. And it only has to be big enough to run this. I mean, we just put a tiny, tiny little hole in there. The entire reason for the wood is just to provide suitable bounce. So if it's not too big. Shouldn't be an issue.
All right, well, you guys decide then. I'm gonna go check out what the Rocket Ladies are doing.
We shall discuss.
All right.
And something.
So you have cord, shock cord.
Yep. I'm gonna go find a piece of paper and a stick out of the scrap so that you don't have to use just your hands.
Careful.
Do we have super glue back in? Yes, we do.
Yes, we do. Go for it. There's some next to Whisker, too. So we got.
So I'm.
Should be ready.
Okay. Making up a shock cord mount. Basically, what we're gonna do is you're gonna glue it to it. And you can glue it this way if you want, and then you fold it up. And you wait for it to kind of be.
Dry.
Together, yeah. And then you're gonna take it, and you're gonna lube it up with glue, and then get it as far in. Is your finger will allow.
Did you say lube it with glue?
Yep. And then just hold it and
go outside.
It doesn't move.
It's not 10 o'clock yet.
And then Just wait until it dries.
No, just wait until it dries. Yeah. Once it doesn't move, you no longer have to hold it. Hey, look, a paintbrush.
Sweet.
Blue brush?
Yeah.
All right. Okay. Cool. And then, Ron, what are you up to?
Putting fins on.
Yeah? Wow. All right. So.
See how hard I'm working?
Super. So,
Kevin is mounting it into the fin guide. Well, which takes a little bit of rigging, because, well.
Well, the problem is, if I can't get this in, I won't be able to get an engine in later either.
Oh.
Is part of the problem the tape, or is it that the...
No, the tape, it makes it dimensionally the same size.
Is the engine thing glued down too hard? The clip?
No, clip's okay. Fine. I have a feeling it's out of round. Or there's glue on the inside of it.
Alright, well, good luck on that.
Well, we're gonna mangle stuff for a bit. Hooray! Two.
Glued the thing.
Awesome.
Gonna wait till it dries a little bit. And then, as Ruth said, put it in the rocket. It's gonna be great.
It's folding over on the edges.
So basically what you're gonna do, we're gonna have to knock out this. So we're gonna cut this little bit out and then tie it to the nose, tie this to the nose cone. So this, when you rock it, because it's two-stage engines, when it pops, it'll pop out the nose cone, but you keep your nose cone.
Oh, okay. That's good.
And we tie the parachute to this. So the two pieces, but there's a parachute. So
I won't lose stuff.
Yeah.
Hopefully.
Potentially.
Maybe I will, but yeah, I might lose the whole thing. But
I lost mine.
I lost the last two of mine.
Wait, I wonder if I still have mine. I think I still have mine from last year. I found it. I can bring it. Yeah.
Bring it.
Why not?
Then you can shoot.
I don't know why not.
You can shoot both of them up and lose one, and it won't matter.
I could lose both.
You could.
Then it won't matter.
Then it won't matter.
You can lose one, and you still get to go again.
That. Great.
Boom. All right.
Yep.
Yo.
So scoot in.
Huzzah! Yeah. That'll be the rocket saving grace.
Yes, well, maybe.
How much do we like this punch?
It will be.
It's hopeful.
How much do we like this,
chisel.
Chisel.
Why? What are you gonna do with it?
Knock out some plastic?
That's fine.
Sweet.
That's fine. It's a ghetto chisel.
Yeah, it is. That's why I asked how much we loved it.
Yeah. There's also, razor blades, but I don't know if
Because if the answer is not really, if I don't feel bad doing this to it.
No, you're fine.
I don't really think it has much of a chance of breaking. It might get a little dull, but we can just resharpen it really big.
Yep.
So you say that, but these exist.
Those are really special.
Yeah, those are not...
Those are...
That was not easy.
Hi, Flint.
Hey, sorry, I just what did a project to? For you, but
oh,
I did it for
fine.
You.
I came back to see what all the hubbub
oh,
was.
Oh, and I got
to
have
to tie
rockets.
Have fun with that one, Whisker. So do we have to tie this in here then?
Yeah.
Kind of, is that how
you
it,
can.
Do you want me to
It doesn't it? Matter, really. Because I assume...
And you
yeah,
have three
You put the launch log
three.
In further than this, so you're fine. You can do it whenever.
Oh, well, I'll do it later then. Just stick this in here.
Yeah.
Don't lose it.
You should leave it out
actually,
so it doesn't glue itself to the...
Yeah. Second thoughts.
Woo!
Oh, yeah. So you'll take it back tonight then, I guess. So you can spray print it?
Yeah, so I can spray print it.
Alright. Alright, so this is a sickle from Ruth's grandpa's granary that they...
Great-grandfather, he may have made this.
I do not know.
We took down the granary.
Uh-huh.
It was cedar that was pretty much turning into, like, feel this. Feel how it's kind of falling apart?
Mm-hmm.
Like the wood itself is dusting.
Crumbly, yeah.
That's what the whole granary was. We avoided taking it down for years because... Lazy. And it was right next to the outhouse.
Okay. No one wants to be next to that.
Well, that and we didn't really like the sun beating on the outhouse.
Yeah.
Yes.
It gave it some protection.
Specifically for putting
mm-hmm.
on fins. It's the best thing ever when you're trying to build like 20
But
rockets.
It fell in and it was time.
Yeah, but we don't
so,
have kicker, so...
None of us got tetanus, which was excellent.
Mm-hmm.
Whisker
might have the kicker, by the way.
The... Oh, yeah, or it's at home. But I don't think it's at home.
We should go.
I can go get it.
Okay.
But sorry, go ahead.
Okay, so.
Well, one of us should get it.
I'll
ask.
Ask Whisker.
So basically, the granary was about the size of this room.
Mm-hmm.
It held grain. It was hand-built.
Mm-hmm.
We took the useful stuff out of it about 15 years ago.
Mm-hmm.
My grandparents stopped farming in 1966.
It's pretty ghetto, but it's way easier than trying to line them up by hand.
This is 2016, so do that math.
Yep.
50 years.
Mm-hmm. And the big thing is that people have done tens of times now.
What we ended up doing, because we didn't throw so many nails.
Parts. Yeah.
Just nails for days.
Oh.
And because we have things like lawnmowers and tractors, we didn't want to just be like,
toss them out. Yeah.
Please don't do that.
So what we ended up doing is taking it out board by board, emptying it out. We found tire chains.
Awesome.
A gear out of the rear end of something that we actually dug up with the box scraper later.
Mm-hmm. That's
A vacuum pump from a milk machine. That was interesting. asbestos fiberboard.
Lovely.
Like 70 plastic jugs. What remained of a coat, which was not much. It was like the zipper and this much fabric.
We have paper towel in here?
No, it's in the kitchen. Oh, there might be some over there.
Check the shop cloth, shop towels.
Oh yeah, we have shop towels.
Are they up there?
It took us about, Ron just walked past them. And there are none.
Check underneath the sink.
Or above in the kitchen. He's not listening. it took us 6 hours because we took it down board by board and put it into the bucket of the tractor and then drove it down to the rock pile.
Mm-hmm.
Oh my god. There was so much in that.
So what do you think you're going to do with the sickle?
I'm not sure yet.
At least getting it a new handle.
Yeah, it definitely needs a new handle.
Cool.
And actually, that's perfect size.
Yeah.
Like width-wise.
Yeah.
What I'm going to need to do, looks like this was painted at one point.
We have black paint, if you want.
Well, no, this was just red at some point.
Oh.
Like you can see there's some here and there's some here.
Oh, I see, yeah.
So I'm in here. We're gonna have to punch out.
That works.
Like drill out the
holes. The world's crappiest rivets.
So yeah. I'm gonna get one
pressure around.
We have
the one. The world's crappiest rivets.
I was gonna get pressure.
Actually, that's.
Nope. Okay. So.
World's crappiest chisel. Let's play with the world's crappiest rivets.
How involved do you want to be in this?
Yeah, that's metal. So. I'm assuming Grandpa did this in the garage. After we get the handle off, we'll run this through the electrolysis bath.
Okay.
Give it a new edge.
Okay.
It's pretty thin. So I'm trying to be careful with it, but it is steel.
Yep.
And then walnut handle.
Like, should I go get cash now, or can we wait till next week to build it?
It should be good.
Cool. All right, well,
we
good luck on that.
Today, and you can give me
cash.
Oh, my
God.
Okay, sure. Straight in. Both.
I'm waiting for directions to stop. I'm going to make a lot of noise.
Making noise.
This is obviously not finished. I'm gonna have to sand down the edges.
And that'll be easy.
Yeah. Kay. This has got kind of a rough edge, but it's a start.
Yep, it is.
Patty.
Yeah. How's the fin stuff going, Ron?
Yeah.
I'm keeping Kevin really busy.
I used to let people be much more involved in this, and yeah. they glued everything to everything. Like, rockets to the plastic, fins to the plastic.
Hey, Kev, this truck doesn't fit. You got another one?
There's another one around here someplace.
I intentionally tried to get you off of the word truck.
You would wait to do the edges until we got the rest of them.
And you're just doing a little hole there?
Yep. And we'll do basically the same thing again.
Zero idea.
Does it fit?
You think so?
You need to hold again?
Okay. Boom.
There's also a good one of me doing this.
And there's our drum backing plate.
Awesome.
I forgot to mention my fingers.
Way easier to get out.
Both sides with one drop right
now. Noise making.
Make a noise. And that was actually.
Okay. Yeah, we do have a normal saw too. Do you want a piece of wood to protect it at all?
We'll wait. I just need to get that out for the next rock.
Oh.
I feel like more Walmart.
Don't run away with that. We'll need that later. I don't think we glued it in, so we should be okay.
Just be able to set it like this.
It took a little bit of force to get in. Oh, go. That was easy.
Oh, I'm really bad at destroying stuff. That I love, so.
Well, you're just restoring it, remember?
I know.
Something to set it in. Something tip. I can just put it down the road.
I got an idea. Here.
This is not easy. Okay.
Maybe they do it on top.
Yeah.
There you go.
Part of the problem is that this is being a.
There we go.
You okay?
Yep. It's just trying its absolute hardest to be as difficult as possible.
So of course. A little after 10.
Yep. And then after the wood glue sets up, we're going to paint it.
I'll take it home to paint.
Okay. We should probably put it on a lug before you paint it.
And carefully, you're about to paint metal.
You can do it either way.
Put what on?
The launch lug that goes on the side.
Oh. Yeah, that thing.
If you paint it with the lug on, you have to make sure that you plug the holes. Otherwise, they get filled up with the paint. Then you're finished. How are you coping?
Not well.
Do you need strong man hands?
Are you trying to mansplain how to use a coping saw?
No, just man strength.
He's got a point.
I think you're doing pretty well.
It's 1,000-year-old cedar.
Is it?
Looks really nice.
So okay. Flint was like,
that
looks fine. It'll just snap right off. Nerp, nerp.
I think I got all the caps on. Yep.
I'm going to use the world's saddest chisel to try to...
Alright. So I'm going to have to try to figure out how to get all of this wood off. And then I'm going to have to find an actual hacksaw to knock off those rivets.
Okay. Well, we'll keep at it then. Alright, so these pieces came off with just a little pry with the chisel there.
We got the world's strangest rivets. Not super certain how I'm gonna do this.
Just the other way. Here.
No, I need to find like a...
Can't you do it like this? Oh no, you can't.
No, I need...
Like that? How about like that?
It's not flat. That's part of the problem. Okay, so we might end up just doing it this way. And just vacuuming later.
Okay.
This must not be cut all the way through. That sounds like metal, right?
Mm-hmm. Probably felt like it, too.
Hmm.
Well, there and we go. That just bell popped off, it's all. Nice.
All right.
Awesome.
Now, since I assume we don't have washing soda.
Don't even know what that is. What's washing soda?
It's like baking soda, but different.
Oh. Nope.
So I'm going to have to wait for Peter. So that I can throw this through the electrolysis bath.
Okay.
And get all the rust off.
I wonder if... Oh, no. You probably can't, like, just... hammer it in or so, hammer it through.
No, because these are flattened metal.
Okay. Well, this way, but no, it still won't.
No.
Okay.
So eventually, this will go on there.
Okay.
We'll figure out something to do with rivets, and then, yeah.
Cool. Sand it.
Yeah, we need to, router.
Router?
Router. To do the edges.
Oh. Yeah.
If do you I come with?
Yeah.
In this way.
Okay.
For the cutting bit.
just need some sanding.
Awesome. Looks good.
It's like one side that's good and the other side's are pretty rough. Yep. So.
Realize you're on the back side of that because the on-off switch is on that side.
All right, so what's the step here?
So the fins are now glued on. We're going to put some wood glue on here just to build things up a little bit structurally. And we need to put a launch leg on, so that's what the metal rod that holds it going straight when you launch it is.
Mm-hmm.
So the key is you want to get it away from the clip. So it has to be either here or here. I'm trying to figure out, I think the tube width. One of these modes will line up right in the middle. Or is supposed to. That doesn't look lined up.
Well, good luck with that.
Yeah. Basically, we're just going to put a straight line on it.
Okay.
Glue with super glue.
Cool.
Totally ignore us. We're just being stupid.
Wow.
Love you, Dad.
All right, so what are we looking at?
So we're capturing the wave.
Yeah.
Of hitting the piezo.
Uh-huh.
So we want to try to capture the ringing here.
Mm-hmm.
But we also want to find out how high it peaks at.
Oh, yeah, sure.
So if we're at 5 volts DC per mark, then we're probably at 15 right there.
Mm-hmm.
And we've seen them get all the way up to 20. Not sure how high it actually will get, so.
This is a Texas.
We have to CI test it out.
Yes. Oh, that's why I didn't recognize it.
See? All the way up to 20.
You don't recognize TI.
So we need to know how to attenuate that or limit that from.
While still getting enough resolution in the ringing that we can use possibly the ringing to detect how far away from the piezo you're hitting, because we noticed that when you hit farther out from center, the ratio between the height of the transient and the first peaking ring is a much lower ratio. See if Flint can catch a good one.
Project before this one, but the first one that worked on, we used a DSP.
Yeah, so you can see the ratio between the initial transient and the first peak in the ring is, you know, the ratio between those two is very low compared to what it was when you hit close to center. So maybe we can use that to sort of give us a map from center out of where the pad was hit.
Are you a drummer?
No.
He's a pumpkin drummer.
There.
Yeah, I would imagine that they're more advanced, but you know, I mean,
just trying to get in the right peak because you can't.
Oh yeah.
Can't really see it otherwise.
And this is with a cap in the circuit, by the way, which made the ringing much more visible.
Cool.
And we can adjust that and add, you know, a voltage divider to keep this from, you know, spiking 20 volts into the ADC and all that sort of stuff.
So anyway,
by the way, it's
that glue did not work
too well.
Output into this, which was great because
experimental.
Cool.
I think you need to put some clips on the edges.
There is something wrong with this.
I think I'll flip it upside down and leave it here all week.
Or if there's a wiring problem, or if there's
something heavy on it.
We finally found out that there's a problem with
hold
one of the library files.
Cool.
I just needed
good
need
job,
to
guys.
Change one number. I need to change you.
There you go.
Alright, Eddie, you see all play four of them. Quiet in the center. You see how it's updating every time you hit it?
Yeah. Ooh, I'm pretty, like, on spot.
Well, it detects a peak, and then that's what it goes by.
Oh. I got two.
Yep.
So are you not getting another musical instrument?
I think she's cuddling at this point.
Holding it. You cannot have my Corella guitar.
Bam.
Does that ring?
Nice.
Awesome.